Yeah.
Do you still think that Billy Joe had the style to beat Canelo?
We believe he had the style to beat Canelo. I'm not sure if Billy Joe did. So,
okay.
I don't want to talk no more about it, but yeah. That's me as a coach.
Yeah.
Did he believe in himself? So, you've got that out of me, Joe.
Yeah, definitely.
Do you know what I'm saying, though?
Yeah, 100%.
I believed in him. Did he believe in himself? But listen, got injured, remember?
He definitely did, and yeah. We'll get back to this weekend to finish it up, because he's such an exciting prospect, heavyweight prospect, Johnny Fisher.
What's good, family? So, mash the like button and subscribe. Oh, man. Billy is down bad. He down bad. Mark Tibbs getting off all over Billy Ho Saunders. This is bad. Yeah, Billy. It's no wonder you stay hiding. You stay hiding. Yeah? Billy Ho Saunders used to be on IFL TV every other week, giving it the giving it all that he would, giving it all that bars, yeah. And now, how many months has it been? It's been about 3 months. That's mad. He fought in May 10th, yeah. May 10th, June 10th, July 10th. Wow, 3 months and 1 week. Billy Ho Saunders been missing. No word of a lie. I've never seen Billy Ho Saunders be down this bad before. He stay hiding. There's no doubt. I've never seen Billy Ho Saunders missing for 3-4 months. And to be fair to him, I have to respect Billy Ho Saunders, because at least he obviously knows how down bad he is, yeah? Because if he didn't, he'd be out and about, wouldn't he? He'd be doing interviews still. He knows how much the public can't wait to get off all over him if he dares pop his head up in public again. He knows. So we have to respect that. We have to respect that Billy knows that we know he's washed. Yeah? And there's no doubt about that. Because listen, any of you goofy Billy Ho Saunders fans, if you've got anything to say, what you need to do is go and find your mans and tell him to pop up. Isn't it? Don't be talking. Don't be commenting. Don't be doing none of that. What you need to do is go find your mans, because don't know where he is. And your man's down so bad, your man's so missing, that even Mark Tibbs is out here getting off over him. Yeah? Getting off all over him. Not sure. Listen, I believed in Billy, but I'm not sure Billy believed in himself. Wow! After all these years, yeah? And Billy Ho Saunders saying, I'll give it a go. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid. I'll give it a go. No word of a lie. I've heard Billy Ho Saunders say things like, well, if worst comes to worst, I'll just bite down and give it a good go, because I believe him. You know what I'm saying? No word of a lie. Of all the things Billy Ho Saunders has said over the years, I'd put top 10, not of what I believe of what he's saying, but in terms of all the, if you were to list, yeah, the top 10 things Billy Ho Saunders was most consistent about, his belief in it, his belief in himself would be top 1, wouldn't it? The way he talked about himself, the way he talked about how sure he was in his abilities. He'd say things like, listen, I just want a fair shake, because I know on my day, if I get a fair shake, no one can beat me. I just know it. Innit? He'd say things like that. He'd say things, I just know. Which obviously, if you just know something, then that means you believe in yourself, don't you? But that's the thing with belief, you see. Especially in boxing. It's one thing to believe something in its own little circle of safety. It's one thing to believe something when you've got Frank Warren purchasing WBO belts for you. Yeah? Isn't it? That's one thing to believe. It's another thing to believe when you've got Canelo Alvarez in front of you, who you've given blue balls for years because you've been running from him. Listen, Canelo Alvarez had blue balls for Billy Ho Saunders. He was rock hard for him. Couldn't wait to unload all upside him. Yeah? That's what did happen. I can't wait for you man to call me a liar. Call me a liar. You man tell me that Alvarez wasn't waiting to unload all over Billy Ho Saunders. Tell me it. Guess what? You can't, because what do we know? Alvarez was in there taunting Billy Ho Saunders. He was warming himself up, stroking himself off, just getting ready. 100%. And the worst thing is, Billy Ho Saunders knew it. Billy Ho Saunders knew what was coming for him. And he checked out. He didn't want no more. Yeah? Alvarez barely put the tip in. Billy Ho Saunders took the tip and hopped out. He didn't want no more. Yeah? He had a little piece of tip and he was out of there. Alvarez, you watched that last round. Alvarez was just warming himself up. No doubt about that. Warming himself up, getting ready for the full stroke. Billy Ho Saunders was just about to get the full stroke. He was out of there. He didn't want no more. Yeah? Fact of the matter is, he got the tip and that was it. Tip and he was out. No more. No stroke. He couldn't take a stroke. That's why. Yeah? Billy the Bottom couldn't take a stroke. It was a tip. Tip and he was tapping out. Tip and tapping. No doubt about that. Oh, YB, why are you always using these weird references? Listen, I'm just using what it was. And if you don't like it, tell your man's Billy to have done something about it. Because listen, what I know is, as a man, yeah, if Alvarez tried putting his tip upside me, you best fight back. Where was the fighter in Billy? What I don't understand is, yeah, for many years, and I've got another video coming soon, but there's a man called, what's his name? What's that goofy, what's his name? Anyway, I can't remember his name. There's some MTK shill, yeah, who was talking about how bare knuckle champions are just bred differently. He was saying, yeah, bare knuckle champions, they're just real solid people, they're just too hard, and if I had to pick a race of people who were just the hardest in history, it would be the bare knuckle champion dons, because they're just super legitimate, and they're just built different, they're raised differently, they're raised to be tough and gritty. I heard all this. Oh, that's it. Spencer Fearon spent about 20 minutes. Don't worry, I'm going to expose it, but let me tell you one more time. Spencer Fearon spent 20 minutes ranting and raving about how bare knuckle champion Donnies were just certified. They were bred differently. They were born differently. Their history, everything made them certified. That's what he said. Yeah? This was before the Alvarez fight against Billy Ho, but either way. In fact, I think it was in the pre-fight build-up. In the pre-fight build-up for the Alvarez versus Billy Ho Saunders fight, yeah? Spencer Fearon was chilling, saying, when someone said, oh, I think Alvarez is going to win, he would say, well, no, I don't know, you know, this is going to be Alvarez's hardest test because these bare-knuckle champion dons, they're built differently. Yeah, there's a different, you know what I mean? They're a different breed. They're bred for this. They've got generations of bare-knuckle champion-ish. Generations? Where was the generations then? And Billy was there, jacking in the corner. Yeah, and Mark Tibbs was begging him to go out and... In fact, now what we know is, after these comments from Mark Tibbs, yeah, we now know what was going on in the corner. In the corner, and Billy Ho Saunders clearly had no belief in himself. Fair lie, that's not fair. That's not fair on Billy Ho. Billy Ho may have had belief, but what happened was, that tip, Alvarez putting that tip in, Alvarez with his tip here pushed the belief right out of him. Do you understand that? Alvarez stroked. Alvarez bottomed. In fact, Alvarez topped. Alvarez topped the belief all the way out of Billy Ho Saunders. Yeah? Pushed it right out of him. 100%. Billy didn't have no more belief left after Alvarez finished hanging at the back of him. Alvarez was hanging at the back of the belief of Billy Ho Saunders had in himself. There was none left. Alvarez had it all. Alvarez was playing with it all. That's what he was doing with it. And Billy knew it, and he checked out. But I just found it interesting that all these things we've heard over the years about how hard these people are, and when he got in there, genuinely, what hardness did you man see? Because I didn't see no hardness. And most importantly, I didn't see no belief either. Because like I was saying, in the corner, yeah? When Billy Ho Saunders got back to the corner and begged Ben Davison to drag him out. Oh, but Ben, you know, oh, Ben, oh, the tip's in, oh, he's about to give me the full stroke, oh. That's what he said, 100%. Billy Ho Saunders said to Ben, he just put the tip in and I can't take a full stroke, so get me out of here. That's what he said, I heard it. If you listen carefully, he says, Ben, he got the tip in. And he's about to give me a full stroke. I can't take it. Get me out of here. Yeah? I'm a celebrity jacker. Get me out of here. 100%. That's what was said. That is what was said. no doubt. At which point, Mark Tibbs, you got to remember as well, Mark Tibbs had spent that whole week build up. Watch, seriously, go back and watch some of them videos. Mark Tibbs just sat there and was almost soaking it up. He wasn't on the bandwagon like Tyson Fury chanting. He just soaked it up and was just clearly watching like a fox, studying the environment. And I think that Mark Tibbs was quite quietly confident that, you know what, after all this talking, after all this chanting, after all of this magic, I think we're going to see a real performance tonight. Because there's no way someone talking and doing all this extra stuff. Let's not forget that in the pre-fight build-up here, when they was facing off Alvarez and Billy Ho, Billy Ho said in particular, "You haven't never seen a heart like this. I was bred for this." Yeah, that's what he said. So obviously Mark Tibbs is sitting there hearing all this, and he's building a level of expectation. No doubt. Obviously, 2-2s, round 9s now, or round 8, whatever round it is, and they're in the corner, and Mark just, I think Mark was bamboozled. He couldn't believe what was going on. And that's why Mark was expecting round 9 to come, because he'd been hearing for the last week and God knows how many years about how much of a brave man and how much of a dog Billy Ho Saunders was. And again, Mark Tibbs says here, "I believed in Billy Ho. I believed in him. But I'm not sure." And this was, for me, was what made this situation peak, was the fact that if I make a video, if the YB makes a video, yeah, and I get off and I punk Billy Ho Saunders, that's one thing. We're enemies. But Mark Tibbs loves Billy Ho Saunders. So do you know how deep this will have cut Billy Ho Saunders? Do you know how peak it is, yeah, for someone who genuinely cares about you to say that, I don't know if he believes in himself? Yeah, it's bad. It's super bad. Because, this wasn't a par. This wasn't an attack. When someone attacks someone, innit, people always say things like that. But it cuts deep when someone's being genuine. If someone genuinely questions your belief in yourself, wow. Like, for example, we've all heard people say, oh, you know what I'm saying? We've all heard them cheap slapstick people throw between opponents. We've heard all that before. That doesn't cut deep, does it? We've all heard people say, oh, you don't believe in yourself. We've heard that rubbish before. But when someone from your own team genuinely says in a non-confrontational way that, you know what, I'm just not sure how much he believes in himself. Ooh, wow, that cuts deep. Billy, honestly, yeah, from the YB to yourself, I was cut for you. No joke. listening to it, it cut me. I can't even lie to you. I refuse to watch that clip back twice because it just cut too deep. It cut me too deeply, so I hate to think how deeply Billy Ho Saunders is cut. You man best believe he ain't going to be on IFL TV for another 3 months right now. Because he missing. Mark, stay cutting Billy deep. But anyway, back to the corner thing I want to finish off before I go. Billy Ho Saunders was in the corner, jacking. And Mark Tibbs, at that point in time, Mark Tibbs believed in Billy. Surely Billy going to go out for round 9 because he'd been talking all this. But guess what? Billy Ho Saunders didn't have no belief in himself, did he? And what I find most shocking is the fact that after the fight, Billy Ho Saunders talk about, we're going to turn orthodox. Truth is, Billy, you wish you wanted to turn orthodox, isn't it? That's the truth. You wish at the end of the round nine, you wish you was thinking like that, isn't it? That's what you mean to say. I wish I was thinking of turning orthodox, because you weren't thinking that. You was thinking to get all the way out of there. You was thinking how you can't take no more of being Canelo Alvarez's bottom. You was done. No more bottom. You was out of there. Yeah? Alvarez topped you, and that was it. He was out. You couldn't take no Alvarez topping. You didn't want no more. You tapped out. Simple as that. Yeah? But to add insult to injury, everyone's lost before. Everyone's jacked before, but what everyone hasn't done is lost belief before. Do you understand that? Oh, sorry, not even lost belief. Mark Tibbs is a legend. Billy Ho Saunders just didn't have it. It's one thing to lose it, but he just never had it. And if you know, actually, if you watch the fight, show me a part in that fight where you can say, YB, watch this part of the fight. This shows Billy Ho Saunders thought he could win. Show me it. Oops. There's never one point in that fight where you see Billy Ho Saunders really bite down and believe he can win. He's always just on the periphery, waiting for that stroke from his top. Yeah? From the bell, Billy Ho Saunders was a bottom. And if you disagree, tell your mans he should have fought back. How about that? He could have come out all guns blazing in any round. And that's why I rate Huey Fury, to be fair, because Huey Fury got a cut, yeah, against, who was it, Pulev, I think. And he bit down on his gum shield and started slapping away. Now, Billy Ho Saunders and Huey Fury, they both have no power. But I'd say Billy Ho Saunders actually has more power than Huey Fury. But Huey Fury bit down and started slapping away. Now, did it have any effect? No, but the point is, he went out on his shield almost. You just folded. You went out like a big bubbly bottom. Yeah? With Alvarez hanging out the back of you. No doubt. And actually, before I go, I've just listened to the last part of the interview again, and it's interesting because Mark Tibbs conveniently remembers his MTK narrative script right at the end, just before it cuts off. So Mark Tibbs spends 2 minutes roasting Billy Ho Saunders' lack of belief in himself. And then he goes, actually, remember that Billy Ho Saunders didn't jack in the corner. Yeah? Billy Ho Saunders didn't have no belief in himself. Oh, he was injured. Yeah? Which, again, in itself, in my opinion, proves that the whole injury narrative's fake news anyway. Because if the injury was true, yeah, then guess what? Mark Tibbs wouldn't ever need to question his belief in himself, would he? He'd say, well, he was just written off with an injury. Is what it is, isn't it? But the fact that Mark Tibbs led with his perception of Billy Ho Saunders' lack of belief in himself, that tells you all you need to know. Don't forget that. The YB was the one who told you what went on from the jump. Back when this fight happened, I told you, listen, Billy Ho Saunders jacked. Billy Ho Saunders rolled over. Billy Ho Saunders is a pillow biter, no doubt. Yeah? He went out silently. He went out chewing on the pillow. 100% confirmed. That's how he did go out. That's always been the case. And now, obviously, Mark Tibbs is just confirming that. Mark Tibbs could have led with Billy Ho Saunders was injured. Isn't it? Human psychology says that you'll lead with what the truth is. He could have led with, yep, Billy Ho Saunders was written off by an injury. And then mentioned a bit about belief on the end. You didn't do that. You spent 2 minutes roasting Billy Ho Saunders' lack of belief. And then you remembered the MTK script writers. And you threw it in at the end. But the YB's already caught you lacking. So Mark, I respect you and honour you and salute you for being honest. Because you're right. You are right. You have now confirmed what the YB's been saying for 3 months. Billy Ho Saunders was beliefless. Alvarez knocked the belief right out of him. The very little bit of belief Billy Ho Saunders did have in himself was knocked out. And Alvarez rode the hind legs off of Billy Ho Saunders' belief. And I guess it's to be fair to Billy Ho Saunders, I guess it is pretty difficult. How can you have belief in yourself, yeah, when you got some next man? It must be hard. I can only imagine. It must be hard to have belief in yourself, yeah, when you got some next Mexican Donny hanging at your backside, innit? Imagine that. Imagine having some next Mexican general hanging at the back of you and then still trying to find some belief. Belief in what? Some next man is riding the hind legs off me. How can I have belief in it? How can a man have belief in himself and some neck Donnie is riding, is topping the hind legs off him. Exactly. So we have to salute Billy Ho Saunders. Billy Ho Saunders found himself in an unwinnable situation. Alvarez was riding the legs off him. No doubt about that. Billy Ho Saunders was being topped half to death, isn't it? Now, I can't speak from experience, but I can just imagine. You're being topped half to death. What can you do? Yeah? So, I think it's time to start showing Billy Ho Saunders some empathy. Because he found himself in an impossible situation. It must be horrible being topped like that. No doubt.